letting go of a thought or quieting the mind. It's common to think of meditation as quieting the mind, but some people will come along and they'll say, oh, you really can't quiet the mind. You can only let thoughts go, that thoughts will continually rise. And all you can do is let go of those thoughts. You can't really quiet the mind. But I know there are meditation practices that are about quieting the mind. I wonder if there's really a difference between the two. There's probably some meditation trick in it all. Well, before letting go of a thought, I think I probably need to go way back in my history. When I was much younger, the activities of my life and my thoughts and my feelings and emotions, all of those were just conflated. They were just one experience. And even when somebody was upset with me or feeling some strong emotion, I couldn't tell whether it was their emotion or my emotion. I'm not sure what thoughts were mine and what thoughts were theirs. I was so in the experience that I couldn't separate myself from the experience. So there was really no question of letting go of a thought. Then, as time went on, I was able to see some separation of the different elements. I was able to say, oh, that's their feelings. This is my feelings. That's their idea, but this is my idea. Being able to differentiate things. When meditating, I feel that I can listen to smaller, quieter experiences. I enjoy that part of meditation where my mind says it's time to meditate, and so my body goes over to the meditation mat and sits in a comfortable position and is still. All the activity is still going on outside, the news and the weather and all the activity. But no, right here in this meditation space, there's stillness, the body still. And you know, I would say that it is my stillness in meditation that allows me to see the activity out there. Before, I was just part of the activity. As I practiced meditation more and more, I could see a little more subtly. And I could say, oh, here's the body sitting here. Perhaps I could watch the breath and begin to feel that flow. But what's interrupting that peaceful flow of the breathing? Oh, these thoughts, images and words and other experiences that I would say are up around here somewhere. You know, the common thinking mind. But I experienced in meditation this differentiation between the body and the mind. Now I could say, oh yes, there's really a thought going on. I can see that thought begin, and I can see it do what it does, and then I can see the thought finish. There's even a small gap, a space of no thinking at all, and then the next thought arises, words, pictures. Then with more meditation, I could actually see that some thoughts I like to push away, some thoughts I like to hold on to. It gets a little confusing because some thoughts are so bad that I want to hang on to them. I suppose I enjoy suffering. And some thoughts are so good that I want to hang on to them, but I feel bad that they're just thoughts and they haven't come into reality. It all gets so confusing inside. But I guess the point is I could see I have attachment to the thoughts. Oh, attachment to the thoughts. Now I'm actually in a position to where not only can I see a thought, but I can see my attachment to a thought, my grabbing it or pushing it away. It's all the same. Now I'm in the position that I can let go of a thought. Not because I make a thought move fast through the mind or that I make the thought just disappear. It's because I'm no longer attached to the thought. It was a good lesson. Somebody very wise told me once that, said, you know, it's not the thought that's the problem. It's the attachment to the thought that causes the trouble. How do I explain it? I have this romantic experience of being a hermit or a monk, a hermit meditating in a cave, probably in India somewhere. And so here I am sitting in this cave, very comfortable. And there's the opening of the cave right in front of me, and a downpour of rain is there. So there's this sheet of rain just out of arm's reach in front. I am sitting dry and comfortable in my meditation cave, and I see this downpour of rain, and I see all the activity going on out there on the other side in that rain. And I can see all the thoughts and activities and all the pleasure and the pain and the suffering and the joys going on out there. And I can just view it playing. And I can be unattached so that I'm not sucked into the rain and sucked into the experience, but I can remain sitting in my cave. And then comes the wonderful realization. It's not so much about the activity. It's not so much about the thoughts. It's not so much about the attachment or becoming detached to the thought. But I realize, look, there I am, the self, sitting in the cave, seeing the activity going on. Oh, yes, I'm in the cave. I'm here. I am here. The self is here, the observer, the one that can observe the attachment, the one that can observe the rain, the one that can observe all the activity. That observer, that self, is here. A truer self than before. I am the truer self. All of this letting go of thought or making the mind quiet is just another step on the way to experiencing the truer self. Yes. So for me, is meditation quieting the mind? Well, perhaps. Is meditation about letting go of thoughts? Well, maybe. Is meditation about having the experience of settling, sitting as the truer self? Yes, definitely. Definitely.